Route 6, the old plant, Planet Fitness, is there somebody here representing that application? All right, we'll table, you know, go back. Second hour, our agenda is a Randall Wright, 297 Neverson Drive. That's also a pre-application.
Hello?
Yeah.
So is that?
Yeah, if you would just, yeah, come up to the podium and state your name for the record.
Hello, my name is Randall Wright. I live at 297 Neverson Drive, and here's my wife, Melissa.
All right, Randy, just kind of explain to us what your intentions are.
Sure, so we have.
Is that on your property there? Is that what we're looking at?
Well, we'd like to say what we would like to do on our property. We're going to change uses of the property. Right now, the property is residential. It's roughly 70 acres between Neversink River and Neversink Drive. We have a single residence there. There's several fields there. 13 years ago, we planted our first apple orchard there in the upper part with the idea that one day it would be a U-pick. That's about 5-acre plot. Several hundred trees are up there now. They're starting to get to maturity. The front lot, which is 5.5 acres behind the Shocks house. There's many Shocks in that area, as you might know.
I'm sorry, when you say separate lot, separate lot?
Oh, I'm sorry, not a lot. There's, when we bought the property 13 years ago, I have a background in environmental, and I'm a science teacher at Port Jervis Middle School. We bought it because we wanted to have a lot of open space and corridors for wild animals to go through it. So when we saw it, there were 3 fields that were open. One field we used for our home, which is about roughly 4 acres. The upper orchard is nearly 7, and the front field, which is closest to the road, is about 6 acres. The rest of it we're keeping for open space and corridors to maintain a lot of organisms that like to use the Neversink River as to move around.
I'm just trying to ascertain if that front 5 acres is part of the 70-acre park. It's congruent. It's all the same.
It's all the same place. We're using it as mixed purpose. So I thought maybe the reasons that we're here is because the property is going to be used for mixed things, or we'd like it to one day. So one would be residential. One would be for open space to maintain that ecosystem that is super beautiful. And the other is agriculture with the idea of being permaculture. Permaculture is when you use, it's not organic, it's when you use organisms and layered ecosystems within a garden situation to grow more vegetables. So basically you have helper plants helping other plants and have a rotation of organisms grazing property between planting to nourish the soil rather than using pesticides, increasing runoff and erosion. So we're trying to go against that. I have a thesis that I did in college about this very area, which was kind of cool, and then buying a property there later. So the way that we're going to change it, I was under the impression that in order to change the purpose, that we should go before the board and make sure you guys are very aware of what we're doing on the property, what we'd like to do on the property. So this year, I started working at Port Jervis Middle School, and I started talking with the grammar schools, middle school and high school, to, there's actually a thing called a farm to school program. It's New York State based, and what the school system is trying to do is get as much local food as possible to our kids to support local agriculture farmers, and to get kids used to, and citizens of New York State used to eating local, eating things that grow locally. We are also working with Simpson's Farm, which is a neighboring farm to us. As of yet, the superintendent and the Board of Education has agreed to buy a substantial amount of mixed vegetables from us over the next 1.5 to 2 years, and allowed us to use the school's infrastructure, including the refrigeration and kitchen, to distribute food and SNAP benefits to local families in Port Jervis, Deer Park area. We would only be open to students and their families and taking SNAP benefits for our pilot, but would like to eventually be able to sell baskets of food to people, either from the farm or through the school, but right now through the school, so we don't have to worry about that until our infrastructure is up. I will need to ask for some permits for infrastructure in the future. We'd like to do some greenhouses and things like that. Another part of the farm to school program is New York York State and the United States government, but mostly New York State through Cornell, which we've met with three times now, want students to be able to see where their food comes from. So we'd like to open up the farm and have the kids pick and harvest their food. And we're trying to do this year. It's on. It could happen this year. It could happen the following spring. But we'd like to do Thursdays where we have salad bars just from our farm. And we'd like to do, and if you do this, it's amazing because the state will pay you. Right now, I think we're getting 8 cents back, or actually, you know, I'd like to not, don't quote me on the amount of money we get back from the state for our food here, but they'll basically give us 10% more back as long as more than 50% of the food at any particular meal is grown within New York State, which is pretty cool. So the school is gonna probably just try to kick that to us. So that's kind of what I have for the beginning there. Also, we're working, I don't know if you know this, but there's this thing in the school system, it's called Project Lead the Way. Project Lead the Way, Puerto Rico school system is trying to adopt some new types of education, which is really based on hands-on learning. You guys have probably heard of STEM or some other types of technology. Right now they call it, you know, what they would call woodshop, they call it tech now. But tech can be a lot of different things. So next year we're working on a curriculum to allow students to come to the farm, especially students who are in life skills classes. Maybe regular school is not working the best for them, so they'd be able to come to the farm 2-3 days a week, get their hands dirty, hang out with the animals, pick some veggies and take it back to school. I'm not gonna charge the school for that. That makes me happy. I will get paid though as a teacher to do that.
Okay. Excuse me, Mr. Wright?
Yes.
What's on in here?
I think this is zone 5. No, I'm kidding. That's a planting zone. I don't actually know. I'm sorry.
You're on Eversink Drive?
I am, yes. Oh, the boss
rural,
knows.
Rural residential.
Rural residential.
Yeah.
Okay. So the short answer is that 1 and 2 family dwellings are the principal permitted uses.
Sure.
And agricultural uses are also principal permitted uses. So basically, I think if you bring us a site plan and tell us what you want to do, then you can probably move forward with your application without having to go to the ZBA.
That's the best. Thank you so much. I don't mean to take too much time.
You're getting into some really, like you're really getting into the weeds.
Sure, yeah, I apologize for that.
My job's to try to keep you.
I appreciate that. That was the best answer you could have given me, so.
Well, but basically, it's, I know it's farm that's.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that's going to be a little interesting about it is that it's a multiple use, but in theory, in a worst case scenario, and frankly, it may be to his benefit to do it, would be to subdivide off the residential lot and then keep everything else at ag.
Yeah, that's true.
Because there may be some tax benefits then to do it that way.
But even though this money that possibly could, as you explained, could change hands, yep. That push that put him in a commercial type of operation?
No, I mean, basically, agricultural uses are agricultural uses as defined. I don't think he says, as long as he's not growing cannabis, we're good. Right now,
say?
No, I'm serious. Because right now, cannabis is
commercial,
not agriculture. So that's a potential problem.
No, we're good.
But if it's an agricultural use, what happens is if he can show that he actually earns more than $10,000 a year, it changes the ability to regulate. But it doesn't change the classification as agricultural use.
He has to develop a site plan. How would I'm going to use a deal with farms here on the planning boards, subdivision or buildings or whatever. How would he actually lay that plot out? He lay a plot out where he intends to be growing vegetables, or how would he do that?
And is there like signage or parking or bathrooms or?
Well, we don't know. I mean, if he's the only one working the farm, then he doesn't need any of those things, right? He's got his house and roadside. If he's got staff, then it becomes more commercial in nature.
But if you have kids who come in here in buses.
And then that becomes something, well, candidly, that may be as much an issue for the school district as it is for the tenant. I mean, we would regulate the parking and the entrance, well, even, and actually even the county would probably do the on-off from Neverson Drive. But other than that, you know, we don't interfere. The school is autonomous. So, I mean, I think we would look at what's being proposed and offer commentary. And depending upon what's proposed, we may actually, you know, really impose regulations. this is new. This is something that none of us has heard about, so I think he needs to come in with a formal plan, show us the portions of his property that he intends to use for what purposes. And then we can make some adjustments or, you know, some analysis.
Yeah, that sounds exciting. So this is actually, as you're saying, this is new. This is actually new all over the place. We were talking with Cornell University, and we've had people from Cornell come in and talk about the farming school program, and they're super excited. They've met with me 3 times, and that's not just me. It's the nutrition department of the Park Service school system, so it's super exciting, and a superintendent and everybody's really excited about it, if we can get it off the ground.
To a certain degree, we're here to try to make that happen.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
You just got to make sure it's done correct.
Absolutely, that's what I'm all about.
So if you can move forward with your plans, go over to planning secretary. She has a packet that you can fill out to present a formal application, short form EAF or whatever. But you get hold of Amanda. She can give you that package. Yeah.
Right. Good to put the
remember her.
We've spoken on the phone.
Yes,
very important.
Spoke.
Very important. Right, but yeah, she'll take care of you.
Wonderful. Thank you for your time.
Well, listen.
Okay.
Thanks for coming. Anybody here for Planet Fitness? Number 3 on the agenda, we're New Century Films. We're going to close out the public hearing portion of that application. That public hearing was opened April the 26th. For oral comment, and we kept it open for a month for written comments to be submitted. I believe we did get some comments today. We may have got some comments tonight.
So, Mr. Chairman, just for the record, so when you did the public hearing, we did it at the Senior Center. That was all recorded. Minutes were taken. There were quite a few written comments received before that public comment. The board received them almost immediately after the public hearing. The board then closed the public hearing for purposes of oral presentation, but held it open for written comment until today. It's already been distributed to all the board members. All of the written comment received between the hearing date and today at approximately 4:58. Mr. Kelson, who's an attorney who will now be representing the applicant, has prepared a letter that I glanced at it briefly. It looks like some of it is comment about some of the other written comment that we've received. It may also further express his client's intentions. So at this juncture, Mr. Chairman, it would likely be appropriate for you to entertain a motion to close the public hearing for all purposes, and then the applicant can look at all the written materials, respond as they deem appropriate. Our consultants can look at all of the written materials, respond as appropriate, and then the board can then move forward by either scheduling a workshop or otherwise addressing the project.
I agree. I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Zachary Kelson. I know that gentleman there from his
years. Long time ago.
Long and another planet, another world. And I'll be representing the applicant. Mr. Plotsky has nailed it. That's exactly what we think you should do, close the public hearing. We've addressed most of the comments that were in beforehand. And I think basically the gravamen of this document, which I've provided a copy for everybody so you can look at it, with some attachments from New York State Parks and Recreation, as well as the Department of the Interior, which deals with some of the issues. Are there fossils? Are there endangered species? I think it covers it all in there. Basically, the gravamen of this letter that I gave you, which is pretty long and 5 or 6 pages, is that we don't believe that a full EIS is necessary. We think that under the circumstances, it's appropriate to proceed as we have been proceeding. And I think we address those issues point, responding to the letter that Russell Moskin, whatever, the attorneys that were representing some of the people that are in here. So I think that basically covers it. We obviously will respond to some of the new submissions. I see that our engineer has a copy of them. We'll circulate them amongst ourselves and provide you with a response within a reasonable period of time.
Great.
So if anybody has any questions, I'm happy to answer them, but.
Without going through your six pages, page by page, I'll have to read and get back to you.
I state we are not paid by the word. That's all I'm going to tell you. If you have no further questions, I'll sit down.
Yeah, I just want to, what's the appropriate timeline for us all to digest all the information?
Well, I would indicate to you, first of all, you have to close the public hearing.
Right.
But once you've done that, Mr. Kelson, do you think 30 days would be sufficient?
Right, you have 62 days to make a decision.
I'm sure that you're going to extend our time to do that.
Of course.
So if you'd like 30 or 45, you tell me how many days you'd like to respond to whatever additional written.
I think we'll need 14 days, really. I don't think we're going to need that much time.
Okay, so then I would suggest that tentatively the matter be calendared for the second meeting in June, and then we can kind of figure out where we are then. That will still be within your 62 days.
Well, we don't need a motion or anything for that. We just want it to be kind of set at the time.
Sure.
When we bring that to a
we want to work with the board. I think we've demonstrated that we've done it. Although I wasn't here previously, I've spoken to the people that were here. We want to work with you, satisfy any concerns you may have,
absolutely,
make any adjustments to the plan that you feel is necessary so that we can proceed. So we're willing to work with you. If Mr. Plotsky needs the extension, he knows to contact me. We'll obviously have no problem with that. Again,
thank you.
I believe the application's complete at this point, so I don't think that's issue that we have to deal with. So I just
we can get the issues addressed in the 14 days, and I think sometime after that we should set a date for a workshop just to go through it all, the unit, just so we're all on the same page. If that
sure
seems like it.
I think once you close the public hearing, we'll take the next step.
Well, we just need a motion to close the public hearing. Comment. Written comment portion of the application. You can make the motion.
Make a motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Yes.
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 That's correct.
All right, the motion.
So thank you, Mr. Chairman. In speaking with Ms. Gore, currently there's nothing on your agenda for June 28th. So if the board members believe that at least, for now, it appears that they'll all be here, we can schedule a workshop for that night. Basically keep everything else off the agenda, except perhaps a pre-app or something should come in.
Do we need to make a motion for that?
No, that you could do that. Just basically indicate that you think that's a perfect timeline.
Okay.
Yes.
There's plenty of time before.
Yeah.
It's a lot to board, a lot of comment, a lot of written.
You want to do that at 7 p.m., I assume you'll be doing that at 7.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And I just briefly asked John if he thought that they would need additional time. He indicated he did not think so. So we should be good for June 28th. We'll assume it's going to be a workshop.
Yeah, I look forward to that.
Thank you very much. And I'm just going to approach for a second because I used to practice with this gentleman.
Good to see you, Zach.
Good to see you. Take care.
Good. Little boobahs, huh? Bisons.
The days of Carl Goldstein. There's two people in this room who know who that is.
Yeah.
Thank you, folks.
Unfortunately, I'm old enough to be one of them.
You and I are the same age, don't forget.
I don't think so.
That's what I keep telling people.
Does you guys have anything you want to comment on your project tonight, or you're good?
I think we're pretty much, we've given as much information as we can. I think that we'll respond to those comments. I've glanced through them. Some of them do deserve to need addressing, and we will do that.
Just want to give an opportunity if you want to say something.
Thank you.
And there again, Old Planet Fitness, no one's here.
14 days ago.
All right, well, whatever.
I just want to
pick up a free. How about the last thing on our agenda tonight is just to approve the May 10th minutes. Do your motion to approve those minutes?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes, and yes. Well, that concludes our agenda. Anything good for the cause, John? John, anything heads up?
I had it.
Sorry. I don't know what time it is. We didn't keep no record, but it's pretty good. The piece of the floor is yours.